Alrighty, Jesse here, aka the Drazer, and I kind of joined this round a little into it, but it is what it is, so let's go. Not really sure what to expect here, but it is what it is. Also, I got a story lined up, or just something to talk about, I guess, for later on in this episode. And that's a goal, so nice. I may end up talking about it this round too, I don't know, it depends. Kinda gotta rethink what I'm gonna say, that way I won't say anything that I'll regret. Let's be real, Jesse, your whole life's a regret. Truth. Got him. Oh gosh, got me good too. Ah, fucking A. Jesse language. Sorry, coach. Job out of that. Beautiful. That was absolutely beautiful. Crap. Thank you so much. Oh, got that little airy freaking flyer thinger dinger going on. That wasn't aerial, I don't know why I was going with that. Oh god, ouch, pain. I need that, thank you. Ooh, Jesse, you suck. Come on, come in. Just realized I've probably been fairly silent, maybe. Ooh, brah. Get in there. Go. Come on. Fudge. Well, that was sad. Got the boost. Come on, kid. It's gonna be a close game. Real close. Sent. Come on, guys. Come on. Oh God, that was terrifying. I could have messed that up so bad too. Ooh, good stop. I was going for it too. Back. I need to calm down just a hair bit. Shoot. That was actually kind of impressive. Not gonna lie. Ooh, almost. Going long. I like how I kind of get so in the zone to where I just forget not to talk. Nah, Jesse, that's a double negative right there. Come on, get it. Sit here for a sec. Shit. It's all you, dog. Thank you. Jeez, this is going long. I'm actually kind of proud of it in the sense that it's just that good, and that's game. Let's go. Beautiful. All right. 3 minutes over. I'll see you guys in the next round. After, I guess, we gotta do that other stuff. I'm just way too tired to realize what's happening. Alrighty, welcome back to the next round. Like I said, I'm gonna start talking about something. So, the topic today is... Now, usually I'm probably not going to give too much information on this, but like, I live most of my life as a secret, if that makes any sense. Like, I prefer to have it where nobody really knows 100% who I am or whatnot. It makes it where basically I can teach people a select few about me in different lights. So, like, no one 100% knows anything about me. Because, honestly, that's how I like it. So, let me explain a little bit more. So, like, one thing that's been a topic on this channel is my borderline personality disorder. Now, I found out that I had it when I was 16 after watching a documentary about Brandon Marshall, who also has it. Come on, Jesse, learn how to drive. Flip over, Jesse. Oh, God. Why didn't it flip? That was dumb. Get out of here. Just clear that quick. Yeah. I learned a lot about myself by learning about somebody else. Because honestly, I didn't realize it was actually like a condition. I just thought I had really intense mood swings, like growing up, where like I'd freak out on people I cared about, and I'd have no control over the situation. Like, so basically, to keep everything hidden about myself, and so I knew I wouldn't freak out on anybody, I isolated myself from any possible situation of dealing with people. Even though people still found their way into my life, it was a lot less than what could have been because of the fact I isolated myself. Now, that being said, I am my own person in the sense that I avoid, I do my own thing no matter what people tell me to do. Granted, people used to try to live through me, but that's kind of what awoke me to the fact that I need to be my own person and do my own thing. So, that kind of formed who I am today, and the fact that I'm still basically the same person I was when I was in kindergarten. The only difference is my emotional issues didn't come into play until I was second grader, probably, close to second grade. Because that's when depression started for me and everything like that. Now we go into kind of like why I hate myself. God, Jesse, you suck. All right, so this is a topic that I don't fully understand why, but I know I do. So, I don't know. Why do I hate myself? Why do I think I do? Or why do I? It's not that I think I do, it's that I know I do. See, that's the worst part is when you know something, but you don't have a reason for it. Like, that's probably the hardest part about depression as a whole is I don't know 100% what causes mine. This kind of happens. Ooh, close. Come on, where are my teammates at? Seriously, where are they? There's one. All right, so hating myself. I don't know, it could be the mixture between all the insecurities I have about myself. Like, I don't know. I don't think I'm attractive, even though I know I've gotten cuter over the past, like, year of my life. That was awesome. Like, the difference between my senior year and my junior year, I've become a lot more attractive, in my opinion. Like, usually I don't talk good about myself, but that's one thing I noticed that has changed. But like, I don't smile because between my depression and my insecurity about my smile, I don't smile often. Like, I'll do like fake smiles just to get people off my back when they ask if I'm okay, which that's a whole different story. When I say I'm okay, I'm not okay. When I say I'm good, chances are that's a lie too. Those are like the only lies you'll ever hear me tell, because if I don't know you, chances are I'm not going to be honest about how I'm feeling. Mainly because I don't want somebody I don't know to care about the situation that I'm dealing with at that point in time. Mainly because if I don't know them, generally it's just like a quick meet up and I'll never deal with them again. So I don't want to ruin their time by making my life a sob story. Get a Jesse on. Fudge. Oh, my nose is running. I need some Kleenexes or something. Oh well, I'll be fine. I'll live. Okay. Oh, he's nice. That guy's sure can dance. All right. So, why? So, like I said, insecurities. And then I don't trust myself. Oh, yeah, that's the big one. I don't trust myself. Because, like, knowing that you can, like, flip emotions so fast, you can hurt someone you really care about without even realizing that you're going to do it. Like, the warning time with emotions is, like, non-existent. So I can go from being the happiest person to depressed. I can go from getting along with someone to suddenly being real angry at them. It's all on impulse. Like, I read a quote that basically said, I don't remember exactly what it said, but what it said is people with BPD lack like an emotional skin. So like the slightest touch or anything can set them off because they're so sensitive to emotion. It's like nuts. And then all right, so enough about why I don't like myself, 'cause that's a topic people hate me talking about. So I don't do it often. Very minimal people actually know that. So if you know that one, congrats, 'cause I don't tell many people that. What else do we got? All right, so my depression as a whole, that's a good one. So the worst part about like my situation at least, God, that guy just gets good shots. Is that the same guy? All right. So my depression at least is generally caused by reoccurring events that have happened in the past. So that's why I have trust issues with people, because it's generally like the same thing happening over and over again. So I kind of isolate myself from those possible situations. Also, for me, every negative thing someone has ever said about me or done to me in my life, like, replays through my head constantly, and I can't control it. So, like, any downtime I get, it just cycles through my head, and eventually, some of the things that people say about you start to believe. And it's like, why would they say it if it wasn't true? You know what I mean? And that's a terrible way to get your body thinking, because it really messes with you. And then what else is there? Yeah, sorry, there's not much visual going on, but I'm just talking, so sorry. Yeah, this episode could go a little longer depending on how long I feel like talking. So, yeah, eventually you start to believe some of the things people say, and it's just terrible to think that way. Like, it can really mess you up in the head and the way you feel. What else has been? The more things I keep secret about myself, God, I really don't want to give too much information on this, because then I feel like people I know find out too much, and I don't want that. Like, if we're best friends, chances are that I'll be okay with telling you this stuff. But you still won't know all of it, but you'll know a good majority. And yeah, it's kind of interesting. And Lucas just messaged me. Yeah, comma, but you can talk you like. All right, so he'll probably end up inviting me to a Skype. He does. So, oh, what did I even say? Oh, best friends and why I only tell them certain things. So there's some things that I just like to keep to myself, and like I said, I only tell like half parts to peeps. So like, eventually it's like a filler in a conversation. If you get two of my best friends that I've had in my life together, they can learn more about me via what I told both of them. It's something that I didn't do intentionally initially, but now I kind of do it intentionally. Because I feel like I can use my life as like an educational piece, I guess. And like I said, my goal is to like get people together and get people happier in life, whether they get rid of their depression or just get people to realize that people are people. Get people together, things happen. But that's difficult for me because I isolate myself. So YouTube's the only way I'll do that now because most of my real life friends are Gandhi. So yeah, woo! Yeah, that's getting too depressing, Jesse. You calm down. Like I still have a couple friends I talk to here and there, but it's nowhere near what it used to be, I guess. So another topic, Jesse, think. What else do we? It's so hard to think right now. I just feel like there's so much I want to say, yet so little time to say it all. All right. So my struggling with people. So I have trust issues with people. I have trust issues with myself. So I struggle to make friends, kind of, I guess. Like, I'm really good at making friends, but like, if I'm in a crowd with two people other than me, I'm okay. If I'm in a crowd with three or more people without me included, yeah. So a total of four or more people, I can't handle the situation well. Like I get silent, I'm not comical anymore. I just force myself, basically I just zone everything out until someone asks me something. Like I'm one of those people that if I'm not forced to do something or told to, I am way too nervous to do it. I don't think it's really the fear of like being made fun of or anything. I just think it's like fear of decision making with people around. Because like if I do something I could influence them in ways that I wouldn't want to. So I don't know, I'm kind of weird, I guess, in that sense. And then what else is there? Actual like dating. Now that's something I fear, I guess. Because since living with BPD would obviously influence that kind of stuff. Like, I don't want to freak out on somebody that I care about way too much. Like, I can freak out on my family because honestly, I don't get along with my family, and I know it's bad to say, but I don't get along with them. It's sad to say, but it's true. What else do we got? Jesus Christ, this game went long without scoring. Come on, Jesse. Oh, God, kid, you got in my way. Oh, well. It happens. All right. So, yeah, actual relationships like dating. I don't know. Like, I've been in a situation like when I was sophomore to where me and this girl, we were basically dating, and I hate telling my basically relationship stuff, but like she didn't count it as one, and she went around dating other peeps, and I really don't know what happened out of that. But yeah. That was super awkward for me, I guess. And The worst part is when people start making fun of you because of that situation. Like, my brother made fun of me all the time for it. It was super sad. Oh gosh, what else? I don't know. I'll see you guys in the next round with some more info on that if I can remember. Alrighty, welcome back to the next round. So, earlier I was talking about my history with like relationship situations. I don't know. There was something I was gonna say just now. I don't remember what it was though. God, that's the worst. All right. So, like I said, we ended up not really dating, but at the same time, it was definitely something you could call a relationship. From what I knew, relationships were then. So, like, looking back now, it was definitely one. But, like, it kind of, like, ruined what the standard of relationships was for me, like, in the sense that, all right, what classifies as a relationship? Because, like, technically this could be one, but I guess it's not, because it would have been my first one, so I didn't really know. And I don't know. So, why we never dated? She told me I was friend-zoned, but little known fact about me, I guess, is that I don't believe in the friend zone. In the sense that if I don't want to be friends, I can just not be friends. So, like, it's not really friend zoning, it's like she doesn't look at you in that light. So, like, you can't consider it friend zoning, I guess. And Lucas is inviting me to a Skype call.
Hello.
Hello. I'm teaching peeps.
Teaching peeps.
Truth.
What does that mean?
I'm educating them on Jesse life. Right
Oh.
now, the topic is my past with relationship situations with women.
Oh my God, Jesse.
All right, so where'd I leave off? So technically, we didn't actually like end up dating, in the sense that, like I said, this was my sophomore year. Sophomore? Freshman or sophomore year? I started talking to this girl when I was in 8th grade. Yes, 8th grade. And we became best friends then. And what happened from there? She was constantly moving back and forth between where I live and a different state. I'm not giving any information on that.
Is this who I think it is?
Probably. I mean, don't say the name, please, because I
It
prefer to.
starts with an.
Don't say it. I will murder
I
you
wasn't gonna
with
say the name,
pain.
I was gonna say what it
Nope, don't
starts
say
with.
it. Don't say it. I have respect
Can
for
I say what
people.
it ends with?
No! I'll tell you later, Lucas. Shut up, I'm telling a story.
Are they related to some one of my best friends?
Potentially.
But just say yes or no, they're not gonna
No,
know
I
who my
don't
best
need.
friends are.
You don't have friends. Alright.
Oh!
Alright, now I'm talking about myself. So, yeah, so that was the situation. What else happened with that? Oh yeah, so I ended up going to prom with that girl.
Yep, it is who I think it
Yeah.
is.
There you go. Which was awkward, no doubt. So yeah, that's basically that, and why I guess she kind of like made it to where I kind of fear relationships, yet at the same time don't understand them. So yeah, hashtag blame her. God, that's the first time I've ever talked about like negatively about someone that I used to like. Like, that ain't me. Like, I usually don't do that shit. So yeah, that's the first and last time you'll ever hear that. All right. What should the next topic be, Lucas?
Something less like that.
Less like that. That's all this episode's been. I talked about why I hate myself. What else should the topic be? Lucas, just give me an idea.
Oh my
Why
God.
My best friend's a cat. That's a good one. Thanks, Lucas.
Alright.
Alright, so my cat may or may not be my best friend. Not the one sitting next to me, though, because she was just bothering me. So, Nader. He's my beautiful cat. I'll flash a picture of his face on the screen right about now. if I remember to do that. So, yeah. So, Nader's my best friend. And he's a cat. So, why is he my best friend? So, I didn't have many friends, like, growing up that I hung out with or anything. So, and like I said, I wasn't much of a people person. I was pretty shy growing up. And that was beautiful, Jesse. So, yeah, my cat kind of became, like, my best friend. Because I didn't have, like, anyone or anything to really turn to. And people get pissed all the time, like, Jesse, how can your best friend be a cat? It's like, my cat's never hurt me mentally. Physically, I don't care about it. You can punch me in the face if you really want to. I don't care. But, yeah. Like, he's never harmed me emotionally, so... And he's, like, never caused me any emotional damage. So how can I not be best friends with him? Like, he's the only thing I know that can't harm me. Excuse me. What? So, yeah. That's going to be the end of this conversation for today. If you enjoyed or want to hear more about why my best friend's a cat, just hit me up and leave a comment. You guys let me know. You guys know what to do. And I'll see you, ladies and gents, on the flip side. Peace off.